Hello, and we're delighted to be here in Fecal for the 36th Annual Traditional Music Festival. And my co-host Marianne is with me here. Isn't it lovely evening, Marianne? We're here ahead of time this time. We're here on Wednesday evening.
Yes, it's a balmy out there, I'm telling you. It would be a great, if the festival goes on like this, it would be great for everyone.
It would be great success.
A lot of the stuff can be done outdoors, which is
great. And you know something, it must be this young concertina orchestra who brought the fine weather. It has to be.
Absolutely, yeah. And they are opening it in style.
Absolutely. So we have one of the tutors of the concertina here is Karen McMahon. You're very welcome, Karen, and thanks for talking to us.
Thanks, ladies. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, you were saying there a minute ago before we came on that you've been teaching the concertina for about 10 years.
Yeah, I have, yeah. Since a young age, I was just independently at home or whatever. But in the past year or so, I've been working with Music Generation Clare.
Yeah.
Teaching classes in the different hubs. So they have hubs in Ennis and Shannon, Killaloe and Assignment. So it's countywide and they're doing great work. So
yeah, Music Generation. Now, for anybody who's listening who doesn't know what Music Generation is, what is it?
Well, it's basically just an initiative that was set up a couple of years ago just to get music going throughout the country. And it's more so about the creative side, like with tonight now you'll see it's in the concert and it's the product. But we'll say the girls that you'll be talking to, they've been part of composing some of the pieces, arranging some of the pieces. So it's more so about the process and the getting the creative juices flowing. As opposed to just your finished product on the day.
Oh, that's fabulous. Sounds great. Marianne?
Were you always interested in the concertina?
I was, yeah. I actually learned from a woman not too far from here, from Mary McNamara in Tuala.
Oh, yes.
And I actually played at this festival about, I'd say maybe 10 years, myself, 10 years ago. So, it was always the concertina that I had. I'm sure there's such a strong traditional concertina here in Clare and with all the young girls and boys that are out there, it's great.
And would you be very aware of the different tones of the concertinas? Or?
Yeah, you would, I suppose. They're all different kind of makes. Yeah. You have the Jeffreys, the Sutners, and then even aside from that, you have your normal tuning and then you have the baritones and different things. So yeah, no, they're all lovely, and it depends on your own style as well, what you like.
And it is one of the instruments, isn't it, that was part of the East Clare tradition going back. A lot of households had
absolutely,
had
yeah. In my houses, and still now, you'd find some up in an attic that might need a bit of tuning, but they're there anyway.
And they're still workable in the...
Exactly, and like even my own concertina now is a Jeffreys, and it's over 100 years old, so the more you play them, the sweeter they are, like a fine wine, I suppose. So
was there a tradition of music in your house, Karen?
Well, Mam and Dad would have played a small bit when they were younger, but they never kept it going. So then I'm an only child, so they said, well, we're definitely going to make sure that you keep going, whether you like it or not. So
and you took to it very quickly, obviously.
I did, yeah. And then with the flacos and the different things, and I kind of had success when I was quite young. And that kind of sets you up for it. Now, I did go away from it for a while when I was starting college, and then you're kind of drawn back into it again without even meaning to be. So, and like, there's such a lovely community of everyone around.
Yeah,
so.
I'm smiling at this when you say when I was very young. I mean, to me, you look like very young.
In my early 20s, yeah. No, under 12, I won the flacco solo. So, very young. Yep.
Yeah. Well, I have the greatest admiration for people who can play with such skill and talent. It's just wonderful. Will we talk to the two young ladies we have here who are part of the orchestra? We have Nicole and Shiva. Shiva, I must get it right. You're very welcome, girls.
Thanks.
Yeah, they're very young. Two very young girls. How are you? Oh, I should never ask a lady her age. But anyway, you look very young.
I'm 17, yeah.
Oh, do you? Well, you don't look 17. And you are?
I'm 11.
Oh, yeah. Well, we were listening to you downstairs doing your little pre-performance practice, and gosh, you make a beautiful sound. When did you start the concertina?
I started the concertina off when I was in senior infants, just the end of senior infants. And my mum's best friend got me started, and I kind of learned quickly and fell in love with it from then.
Yeah, isn't it wonderful? Yeah. Marianne?
It seems to be one of those instruments that's very user-friendly, for want of a modern word. From what I can see from people learning it, even compared to an accordion or to another instrument like that, would you find that?
Yeah, it is. It's just kind of...
I'd say it is very difficult.
Yeah.
I would, because, well, with concertina, as far as I'm aware, you have the melody, but you also have the accompaniment.
Yeah.
And that's difficult, I think, because that takes a long while to learn.
The bellows and all the different notes.
Well, for me, anyway, who's a a Luddite in these things. It seems very, very, very complicated.
Well, and I'm glad to hear that, because the girls make it look so easy.
They do. What about you? Just, you started when?
I started around second class, I think.
Yeah.
Well, I played the fiddle before that, but I didn't like it, so I changed.
You didn't care for the fiddle.
And my mum started me off in the tin whistle, so she kind of started. I have two brothers as well, and we all started off in the tin whistle, and then picked on another instrument to go on.
Yeah. And if somebody took the concertina off you now, would you be able to play the tin whistle?
Probably. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go, you see. Multi-talented, isn't it? Yeah. And are you part of the music generation for long?
I think I started last year.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do you like it?
I do. Yeah.
It's a bit different from traditional learning, isn't it?
Yes.
Because you're involved in so many other aspects of it. I'm really looking forward to hearing some of the pieces that you've written for the orchestra.
Yeah.
That'll be part of tonight's concert, won't it?
Yeah.
Do you have to spend much time practicing, Nicole?
Yes, loads.
Like, tell me what's loads.
Well, now I'm in the FLA coming up this weekend.
Oh, yes, you're all going to Mullingar.
It sounds ridiculous, but I'd be doing 2 hours a day.
Oh, yeah. Is there any time for anything else in your life? Apart from school now, of course. Yeah.
I do a bit of camogie, but
yeah,
music would be my number one.
Yeah.
Music is also one of those things that's international, and you can travel with it. And it's a great, from other times, I've seen that for people going to college, going out into the world, mm-hmm. if you have a musical instrument with you, you're immediately part of a crowd. So it always helps.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Karen, back to you. Where do you see yourself going to from here now? Will you set up a school of your own, or?
I don't know. At the minute now, I'm starting with the orchestra in September. Mm. I was always going to the concert and different things and just doing the private lessons. But this year I'll be one of the tutors alongside Sinead Mulqueen, Conor Lachlan, and Killian King, and of course Tim and Pádraig. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I'll definitely give that a good go for the however long it lasts and see how that goes. I suppose I'm a primary teacher by day, so it's nice to have the music in the evenings at the weekends, and we do a good bit of gigging then at the weekends as well. So yeah, there's always something with it, in fairness. It's a great sideline.
Yes, a lot of primary teachers play music, don't they? A lot of teachers play music, don't they?
Yeah, and it's lovely to bring into school as well.
Yeah, absolutely.
And especially for the sacrament classes, it's lovely to have something for the mass.
And you teach in Clare?
I do, yeah. I'm below in St Aidan's in Shannon.
That's
the past couple of years.
That's great.
Yeah.
So can I just ask, I know this is probably a little bit on PC, but is it very much a woman's instrument? Or does it cross the board? I see you, Geraldine, reacting like this. But I'm thinking in terms of the fingering, you know, to being able to access the buttons and to...
I mean, like, if you look back at history, you couldn't say so. Like, especially in Clare, you have Noel Hill, Jack Talty, Paul Grin.
He was the man, wasn't he?
Yeah, yeah. Kind of got it all going, yeah. And even Conor Lachlan, who's in this with us, like, he's big strong man, and there's no bother with him getting his fingers around the instrument. So I suppose maybe at first glance you might think so, but no, the men have it as perfected now as much as we have. Yeah.
I'm glad to hear that.
Oh, Marion, I think it was just wonderful to see the girls. We better let them go back because they're kind of building up to their performance. Is there anything you wanted to say, Karen or Nicola or?
No, I suppose it's just great to get the opportunity to perform at different things like this. Like, the girls have got to work alongside some of the best known musicians in the country, do you know? So Music Generation provides such wonderful opportunity for young people just to explore different things that they normally wouldn't, we'll say, with the normal structure of the flacule or different things like this. They get to do all different things. So yeah, I would definitely encourage anyone that is into music that get onto one of your local hubs. They're in Ennis, Killaloe, Shannon, Ennis Diamond. And even further afield, they're countrywide.
That's
so
great.
So definitely try and get involved.
Shiva, are you going to the flat in Mullingar?
Yeah, I am. One of my brothers is in a band on the piano, so we're going up.
Gosh, such talent. And will you tell your mummy and daddy to listen to this interview on Saturday on Scariff Bay Community Radio, will you? And they'll hear you talking. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you so much, all of you.
Very best of luck in the flat.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Are you entering competitions? You are, of course.
Well, I'm long gone.
Not you.
But Nicole is in the under-18 concertina. Which is a hugely competitive competition, but we wish her all the best. I'm sure she'll do
we
great.
Do. And we do. We're looking out for the results now.
Yep. No pressure.
Thank you so much, the three of you. Thank you so much. And we'll be looking forward to the concert tonight.
Enjoy the flair, whatever about any other part of it.
And enjoy playing tonight too, because we're looking forward to hearing you.
Yeah.
Thanks so much.